بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. Now inshallah we're discussing the ta wa ta'nis as-sakina. So we're now right here, the close to the end. So ta wa ta'nis as-sakina تلحق الماضية لتدل على تأنيث ما أسند إليه الفعل. التاء التأنيث الساكنة it comes at the end of a فعل ماضي to denote that the مسند إليه meaning the فاعل of the فعل is مؤنث. So for example ضربت هندون. So this تاء is a separate حرف on its own and it is an علامة التأنيث. It shows you that the فاعل ما أسند إليه الفعل meaning the مسند إليه the فاعل that is مؤنث. Okay, وقد عرفت مواضع وجوب إلحاقها. And when we're discussing فاعل, we already mentioned where the فاعل has been مؤنث. أي ضربت. You have قالت الأعراب, قال نسوة, etc. etc. We've done that discussion a long time ago. وإذا لقيها ساكن بعدها وجب تحريكها بالكسر لأن الساكن إذا حرك حرك بالكسر. And when there's a ساكن after it, then it is necessary to make that into a متحرك بالكسر. Because the rule is, very important rule, is ساكن إذا حرك حرك بالكسر. So if you have قد قامت الصلاة. Now when you have A, what comes after it? إذا لقيها ساكن. So you have one ساكن here, and then you have another ساكن, because obviously شدة is ساكن plus فتحة. So you have two ساكن. So when you have التقاء ساكنين, you have to do what? You have to give حركة to join it together. So you give this one a كسرة. So قد قامت الصلاة becomes قد قامت الصلاة. Very basic stuff. And now he says here وحركتها لا توجب رد ما حذف لأجل سكونها فلا يقال في رمت رمات المرأة. Okay. لأن حركتها عارضية لرفع التقاء ساكنين. So look, what do we have here? We have the verb رمى. When you have رمى, it's رمى, رميا, رموا, رمت. But originally, رمت was really رميت. Yes? Correct? رميت. When we have رميت, we have رميت. So what do we do now? We said, يا متحرك ما قبله مفتوح. So it becomes رم. So the يا becomes an أليف. Then it's صرف already. رمات. So it becomes what? رمات. Because you can't have اجتماع ساكنين, you say, you drop this and it becomes رمت. Yes, everybody following? So you have ramayat, the ya becomes an alif, it becomes ramat. And because of ramat, ijtima'u sakinain, we drop the alif and it becomes ramat. Now we're saying here, what if I say it? What if we have ramatil bintu? Ramatil bintu. Why can we not go back to the asal and say, well, the ramat was an issue, but when we give this a sakin, when you give this a kasra, if you say Rama Rama Til Bintu, there's no ijtima'u sakinain here because Rama Til Bintu is one sakin. So Rama Til Bintu, why can you not bring that back? So we're saying here wa harakatuha, giving a haraka to the alamatu ta'ni, to the ta'u ta'ni sakina for ijtima'u sakinain does not necessitate bringing back the alif or any letter which was removed because of it being sakin. So the alif in ramat or ramata, for example, will not come back if this becomes mutaharrik. So you will not say ramat, you will not say ramat al ramatil mar'atu instead of ramat. Why? Because we say here, لأن حركتها. This kasra is aridiyya, it's arid, it's not original asra, it's only there temporarily. لرفع التقاء الساكنين. So we don't get ramat, ramat. So this kasra is here, but only because of this. It's not an essential or built-in part of the verb. So therefore, we can't base a rule upon this. So you can't bring the alif back. The alif which has been removed will stay removed. Okay. وقولهم المرأتان رماتا ضعيفٌ. I don't know who said this. Maybe it's one logo. I checked. Nobody's. I've not seen anybody mention it. But he says here that maybe some people have said ramat ramata. So they're saying, well, so we have here. We know is ramayat. Ramayat and Ramayata. 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 So Ramayat becomes Ramat, then it becomes Ramat. So Ya becomes an Alif, becomes Ramat, Ishtima'u Sakin becomes Ramat. Now there's two ways of doing Ramayata. Do we make do we make ramata from this ramat, and then from here we say now add alif ramata for jewel. That's what we do. One argument could be, well, we go this way, ramayata. So ramayata, why don't we just give the ra ramata, change the ya into an alif, there's no ishtimal sakinain, keep ramata. So instead of basing it on ramat, why not base it on the asal? He said this is one opinion, but it's da'if. So we will, when the ya becomes, the alif becomes mahzuf in the mufrad, it also becomes mahzuf in the muthanna. But for argument's sake, you can have ramata, but that's a da'if opinion and people haven't gone towards that. Have you understood this? Yes? Okay. Now moving on. So we know that we have alamatu ta'nith. We can add the ta onto the fi'l madhi. Can we also add alamatu tathniya and jam'ul mudhakkar and jam'ul mu'annas? He says here, amma ilhaqu alamati tathniya wa jam'il mudhakkar wa jam'il mu'annas wa da'if. As for adding the alamatu tathniya and adding jam'ul mudhakkar and adding jam'ul mu'annas, alama is da'if. This is basically what we then akaluni al-baraghith. وَأَسَرُّوا النَّجْوَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. We explained it there. So what happens, there's one logha, I don't know, remember the people, but it's أَكَلُونِي الْبَرَاغِيثِ. So قَامَ الزَّيْدَانِ, there's two ways of doing the إعراب here. One is قَامَ is فَعِل, أَلِف is the فَعِل, and this is بَدَلٌ مِنَ الْفَعِل. Yes, that's one way. That's the same way, أَسَرُّوا النَّجْوَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. So we say here, asarru is fa'il fa'il, the waw is the fa'il, and alladhina zalamu is the badal of the waw. Another way of doing it, you say here, qama is the fa'il, the alif is alamatu tasniya. Alamatu tasniya. And al-zaydan becomes the fa'il. Yes? Okay? That's two ways of doing it. But this is only the akaluni al-baraghith vocabulary dialect. It's not spoken like this, but there's a few ahadith like this. Remember that one? يَتَعَاقَبُونَ فِيكُمْ مَلَائِكَةٌ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَمُخْرِجِيَّهُمْ or وَأَسَرُّ النَّجْوَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. So it is used, but what we say here is, this is not common. I would say da'if, it's not common, because it has been used in the Quran. So da'if is maybe not the best way to say it. It's uncommon. So generally speaking, you won't say قَامَ الزَّيْدَانِ أَنْ قَامُوا الزَّيْدُونَ أَنْ قُمْنَا النِّسَاء. You would say قَامَتِ النِّسَاء. Okay. وبتقدير الإلحاق. If you do accept it and you do allow this إلحاق, you add the تسنيه sign, you add the جمع sign, جمع المؤنث sign, then there won't be ضمير. Yes? You wouldn't have ضمير. You wouldn't say this is ضمير. You wouldn't say here that the ألف is a ضمير or the واو is a ضمير or the نون is a ضمير. Instead, you would say what? You would not make those a ضمير. لألا يلزم الإذمار قبل الذكر. Because what would happen? You have إذمار قبل الذكر. You have ألف referring to the زيدان. And you have إِذْمَا قَبْلَ الذِّكْرِ. This is his opinion. You want to do this. He's saying, what would you say? بَلْ alamat. You would say there are alamat. There will not be ذَمَائِر, but there will be alamat which denote the أَحْوَالُ الْفَائِلِ كَتَاعِ تَعْنِيفِ. When you have ضَرَبَت, the ta is not the fa'il. The ta simply denotes that the fa'il is مُؤَنَّث. So if you have قَامَ الزَّيْدَان, even though it's an uncommon logo, if you do bring it in, then the قَامَ الزَّيْدَان, the alif wouldn't be the fa'il. Alif will be alamatu tasniya. The same way the ta denotes the femininity of the fa'il, the alif will denote the duality of the fa'il. And qamu al-rijal, the wa would denote the plurality of the fa'il. And qumna would denote the femininity and the plurality of the fa'il. There wouldn't be fa'il. And the other opinions know that they are the fa'il and the word after is badal. And this is not common. If ma qabla dhikr, yes, again, rule of thumb is not allowed, but you have things, for example, you have الزمير المبهم ساءت مستقرة. You have a zamir which become مفسر. A zamir المبهم which is the tafsir after it. You can have that zamir المبهم. It creates more إذمار قبل إبهام. توضيح بعد الإبهام is a way of in balagha. If you bring something ambiguous, then you clarify it. So we have mentioned some of these before, like in the ni'mah. So ساءت مستقرة. So we say مستقرة is doing tafsir, tamiz of the zamir inside. So having a zamir or something ambiguous and clarifying it is not a big issue. So if we say qama al-zaydan and make alif the fa'il, it's not a big issue. If you want to make alamat al-tathniya, you can also do it both ways. It's not a big issue. Okay? But if you do make it alamat al-tathniya, it'll be a difference in the Arab. In here, this will be fa'il And then here, this would be a harf. So this would be a ism. So if you say fa'il, ism, fa'il, and you make alam al-tasniya, then it becomes a harf, which just denotes the duality. Yes, have you understood? Yes, any questions? Okay, we stop here inshallah. Subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayka.